Thing to do on playing card unboxings because sometimes they don't end up breaking the right way. But looks like I got it right today. must be Steve Cohen. There's the Ace of Spades, which is always the source of much anticipation for me whenever I open up a new deck of playing cards, because the Spades, Ace of Spades, is almost always the most customized card in the entire deck. And honestly, I'm not that impressed by this one. It looks pretty much the same as every other card, every other Ace of Spades, but and the back design of the duck case here, they didn't really change it out a whole lot, which is something I like to see. And the Ace of Spades is a little bit more unique illustration than just ripping off the back of a duck case. And that's just a personal preference. I know it's actually pretty expensive to get a designer to create a completely custom Ace of Spades, but I've come to appreciate it and almost want to see it every time. The face cards have pretty much a standard illustration. Faces look like they're actually changed a little. And the color palette is a pretty bright yellow that I'm not used to seeing. And with the faces, they're kind of pink. You can probably see that. Yeah, look at the expression. It's a little bit, that's the custom aspect, probably. Seeing these cards when they first came out, and I wasn't super impressed, so I didn't buy them, but seeing them in Borders gave me the good opportunity to pick up a box without having to pay for the online shipping, which is typically the case with most playing cards that I buy, that I have to pay the shipping cost. With a double backer, which is pretty standard, and another joker. A lot of people ask me why you get a double backer card, and it's for magicians, and the easiest thing I can show you is we're doing what they call a double lift. Show you a five of hearts here. Oops, I'm gonna do this. That's crummy. I'll try again. I show you a five of hearts here. I bury it in the middle of the deck, and then five of hearts back. So that's one application of using a double backer card that magicians do on a regular basis, probably. Well, maybe not magicians, but magician enthusiasts, perhaps. adds a little extra something to the cards. There's some Latin written on the back. Carpe diem. Carpe noctum, which I don't know what that means, but carpe diem means seize the day. Sound of these duck cases when you tap on them. When they're empty, this is such a cool joker. It's a full bleed. And it's a gold sort of metallic looking ink. Circa Trova. Contraband. Wow, I really like this joker. This must be the back design, which we have yet to see. But I have high hopes now that I've seen how ornate the Jokers are. Oh my god. That's really awesome. This Ace of Spades is so much better. So much better than the Tycoons. I can't even tell you. So ornate, and this one stamp of color down here is just such a nice touch. I'm really digging this. Whoa, and look at the pips here have kind of a faded look in the middle. Even over here in the corners, they're faded. It's kind of a pixelated look. Smaller, and definitely the numbers are thin. Says that Theory 11 creates the world's finest playing cards. The perfect gift. And an amazing piece of art. Theory11.com. I wholeheartedly believe that and agree with it. What a cool deck. A nice surprise. And the fan. I don't know if you can tell, but edges were designed, you get that cool little effect when you do a fan, which is one of those details where you know the designer worked with a cardistry folks or magicians to make sure that the way that they're used is really featured and highlighted in the design and how you manipulate them. Cheap that I got at Walmart. I've seen these online, but I've never bought one. Warrior horse on a traditional bicycle with an air cushion finish. Says a warrior horse. People born in the horse years are active and energetic, charming and cheerful, hardworking and self-possessed and sharp. The horse is extremely likable and skillfully acquires power, wealth, and respect. Special. Well, different color ink. And the ace of spades, the pip is normal, but this is custom to the deck. Gold ink. And it says warrior horse. I will say that the back design is pretty awesome. Don't you think? This is a pretty standard looking deck. That's not standard though. The general design of the core card itself is standard, but the designer took the liberties in giving it a background color in black to fit the deck style. these aces are pretty boring compared to the contraband, right?
Bicycle auto.
inside of these pips. They are the same as the, there's a deck of animal cards. I think it might be my last deck to show you. Okay, so some variations on the court cards design, but pretty standard for the most part. I do love the look of these custom pips though. Just really modern in the interpretation of the pips. About this deck. Bicycle brand autumn playing cards blend old with new. This historic back design features crisp autumn colors and has been modernized by printing with metallic inks in celebration of the contemporary trend of mixed metals. For over 130 years, bicycle brand playing cards have brought people together in the name of friends, cards, and memories. That's kind of nice. And then we're in French as well. Alright, so for a relatively standard bicycle back design, rider back design, these are pretty cool. I like them better than the Warrior Horse. And last but not least, I have one more deck, I think. Looks like I got two of the autumns. Any surprise which one is my number one favorite, so I'll start at the bottom. These, I would say, are probably my least favorite of my haul that I bought. They're just too generic looking for me. I like a little bit of unique design in my cards. I thought that with the duck case design being different than usual, that I'd see something a little bit more custom, but I was wrong. design and the inks that they use and the colors and the background of the base cards, but they just don't, they don't do much for me. They're a bit better, more specialized than these seconds. After that, my next favorites would be these autumn cards because they, they're bicycles but a little bit more specialized in their inks and their look and feel. Second to last are my other tycoons, which, they're not bad, they're pretty cool, but ultimately, as cool as my number one. The contrabands, these are by far my favorites in this haul. The duck case design is just, I mean, really exquisite. I mean, all of the illustrations, the design of her and this deck are exquisite. A lot of attention to detail. And a story that I'd love to know more about. The amount of customized cards, the aces, is just really amazing to me. I'm just noticing now that there's kind of a Freemasons logo here, so that has something behind it.